Time series topic tracking can help us understand how the topics change over time for reviews or social media posts. In this tutorial, we will use Airbnb review data to illustrate the following: how to process the data to remove the noise in the topics, how to build a transformer-based topic model in Python, how to track the topic change over time. The Python package used for the topic model in this tutorial is BERTopic. For more details about using this package, please check out my previous tutorials, Topic Modeling with Deep Learning Using Python BERTopic, and Hyperparameter Tuning for BERTopic Model in Python. Let's get started. In step 1, we will install and import Python libraries. Firstly, let's import BERTopic. After installing the Python packages, we will import the Python libraries. Pandas and NumPy are imported for data processing. Seaborn is for visualization. NLTK is for removing stop words. UMAP is for dimension reduction. HDBSCAN is for clustering models. Count Vectorizer is for term vectorization. BERTopic is for the topic modeling. The second step is to download and read the dataset. A website called Inside Airbnb had the Airbnb data publicly available for research. We used the review data for Washington, D.C. for this analysis, but the website provides other listing data from other locations around the world. Please follow these steps to download the data. 1. Go to http://insiderm.com/get-the-data. 2. Scroll down the page until you see the section called Washington, D.C., District of Columbia, United States. 3. Click the blue file name reviews.csv.gz to download the review data. 4. Copy the downloaded file reviews.csv.gz to your project folder. Note that Inside Airbnb generally provides quarterly data for the past 12 months, but users can make a data request for historical data of a longer time range if needed. Those who are using Google Colab for this analysis need to mount Google Drive to read the dataset. You can ignore the code below if you are not using Google Colab. Drive.mount is used to mount to the Google Drive so the Colab notebook can access the data on the Google Drive. os.chdir is used to change the default directory on Google Drive. I suggest setting the default directory to the project folder. pwd is used to print the current working directory. Please check out Google Colab tutorial for beginners for details about using Google Colab for data science projects. Now let's read the data into a pandas data frame and see what the dataset looks like. The dataset has multiple columns, but we only read the comments and date columns because the reviews and dates are the only information needed for this tutorial. The dataset has over 300,000 reviews. We read 10,000 reviews to make the computation manageable and save time for each iteration. The date column is object type by default. We changed it to date time format using the infer data time format equals true argument. .info helps us to get information about the dataset. From the output, we can see that this dataset has 10,000 records and no missing data. The comments column is the object type and the date column is the data time 64 type. The time range for the ERB review dataset is January 20, 2009 to September 14, 2022. To examine the number of reviews by year, we extract the year information from the date column using datatime index.year and save it as a separate column. Airbnb was founded in August 2008. The count plot shows that there were very few reviews in 2009. The number increased over the years and became relatively stable from 2013 to 2019. There was a big drop in the number of reviews in 2020 due to COVID. Although the number of reviews are increasing since 2020, it is still much lower than the number before the pandemic. In step 3, we will remove the noises from the top words of the topic model. There are three types of noises that impact the topic modeling results and interpretation: stop words, persons' names, and domain-specific words. Stop words are the words that commonly appear in sentences but have no real meaning, such as the infer. There are 179 stop words in the Python package NLTK. Persons' names are high-frequency words for Airbnb reviews because reviewers like to mention hosts' names in the review. Therefore, names are likely to become top words representing the topic, making interpreting the topics difficult. To remove the host's names from the top keywords representing the topics, I downloaded the frequently occurring surname list from the US Census Bureau. It contains the first names with a frequency of more than 100. There are two columns in the US Census Bureau surnames frequency dataset. We only read the column name because only name is needed for the tutorial. After reading the names into a pandas data frame, they are transformed from upper cases to lower cases because the topic model uses lower cases. Two name lists are created using lowercase names. One list has the names, and the other has the name plus the letter S. This is because a lot of reviewers mention the host's apartment, such as Don's apartment. The word Don's becomes Don's after removing punctuation. So we need to remove the name plus the letter S from the top words as well. Each name list has 151,671 names, and the top three names with the highest frequency R. Smith, Johnson, and Williams. Domain-specific words are high-frequency words related to the business. For Airbnb reviews, reviewers frequently mention the word Airbnb, time, wood, and stay. Because I am using the data for Washington, D.C., the word D.C. is a frequent word too. Removing noises is an iterative process, and we can add new words to the list if they do not provide valuable meanings and appear in the top topic words. For example, some less common names such as Natasha can appear as top words. The word also appears in the top words too, but does not provide valuable information about the topic, so we will remove such words. To remove the noises from the top words representing the topics, we extended the stop words with the name lists and the Airbnb-specific words. After the extension, 303,529 words are excluded from the top words. In step 4, we will talk about how to build a topic model. In this step, the time information is ignored and all the reviews are used to build the topic model. The output from the topic model will be used as the foundation for the time series analysis. BER topic model uses UMAP dimensionality reduction. BER topic by default produces different results each time because of the stochasticity inherited from UMAP. To get reproducible topics, we need to pass a value to the random state parameter in the UMAP method. NNeighbors equals 15 means that the local neighborhood size for UMAP is 15. This is the parameter that controls the local versus global structure in data. A low value forces UMAP to focus more on local structure and may lose insights into the big picture. A high value pushes UMAP to look at the broader neighborhood and may lose details on local structure. The default NNeighbors value for UMAP is 15. NComponents equals 5 indicates that the target dimension from UMAP is 5. This is the dimension of data that will be passed into the clustering model. MinDist controls how tightly UMAP is allowed to pack points together. It's the minimum distance between points in the low-dimensional space. Small values of MinDist result in clumpier embeddings, which is good for clustering. Since our goal of dimension reduction is to build clustering models, we set MinDist to 0. Large values of MinDist prevent UMAP from packing points together and preserves the broad structure of data. Metric equals cosine indicates that we will use cosine to measure the distance. Random state sets a random seed to make the UMAP results reproducible. Count vectorizer is for counting the word's frequency. Passing the extended stop words list helps us to remove noises from the top words representing each topic. In the BER topic function, we tuned a few hyperparameters. To learn more about hyperparameter tuning, please check out my previous tutorial, Hyperparameter Tuning for BER Topic Model in Python. UMAP model takes the model for dimensionality reduction. We are using the UMAP model for this tutorial, but it can be other dimensionality reduction models such as PCA. Vectorizer model takes the term vectorization model. The extended stop words list is passed into the BER topic model through count vectorizer. Diversity helps to remove the words with the same or similar meanings. It has a range of 0 to 1, where 0 means least diversity and 1 means most diversity. Min topic size is the minimum number of documents in a topic. Min topic size equals 200 means that a topic needs to have at least 200 reviews. Top n words equals 4 indicates that we will use the top 4 words to represent the topic. Language has English as the default. We set it to multilingual because there are multiple languages in the Airbnb reviews. Calculate probabilities equals true means that the probabilities of each document belonging to each topic are calculated. The topic with the highest probability is the predicted topic for a new document. This probability represents how confident we are about finding the topic in the document. Using the attribute getTopicInfo on the topic model gives us a list of topics. We can see that the output gives us 9 rows in total. Topic minus 1 should be ignored. It indicates that the reviews are not assigned to any specific topic. The count for topic minus 1 is 2442, meaning that there are 2442 outlier reviews that do not belong to any topic. Topic 0 to topic 8 are the 9 topics created for the reviews. It was ordered by the number of reviews in each topic, so topic 0 has the highest number of reviews. The name column lists the top terms for each topic. For example, the top 4 terms for topic 0 are clean, neighborhood, restaurants, and bed, indicating that it is a topic related to a convenient neighborhood. In step 5, we will talk about how to generate topic representations for each topic over time. The Python BER topic package calculates topics' evolution over time based on the topic model output. The class-based TF-IDF will be calculated for each topic and timestamp combination. There is no need to rerun the topic model multiple times to create clusters from embeddings for each timestamp. To get the topic representations over time, we can apply the topics over time function on the topic model and pass in the reviews and dates. Global tuning equals true indicates that the topic representation at a certain timestamp is averaged with the global representation of the topic. This helps to increase the similarity between the time-specific topic representation and the overall topic representation. Evolution tuning equals true indicates that the CTF-IDF at time t is averaged with the CTF-IDF at time t minus 1. This moving average step allows a stable evolution of topic representation over time. Both global tuning and evolution tuning have the default value of true, but we can change it to false if we do not want the topic representation influenced by the global topic or the previous timestamp. NR bins controls the number of unique timestamps. BER topic suggests keeping this number below 50. NR bins equals 13 means that there will be 13 equal-sized bins for the time. The output of topics over time is saved in a pandas data frame. The data frame has four columns. The column topic has the topic number from the topic model. The column words has the top word representation for the topic at the specific timestamp bin. The column frequency has the number of reviews for the topic in the specific timestamp bin. The column timestamp has the timestamp cutoff points for the bins. In step 6, we will talk about how to visualize the topics over time. The visualize topics over time function takes in the topics over time data frame and produces the time series graph for topic changes over time. We can use top n topics to limit the number of topics to show in the time series graph. From the topics over time visualization, we can see that topic 0 consistently has the highest review volume since 2010 compared with other topics. Other topics have similar review volumes. Topic 0 has an upward trend over time before the pandemic, while topic 3 and topic 4 have downward trends since 2012. Hovering over the timestamp cutoff point shows the topic representation for the topic at that specific timestamp bin. We can see that reviews in topic 0 talk about parking a lot from 2012 to 2015, and parking was not a hot topic anymore between 2016 to 2019. People care more about neighborhoods and restaurants over time. The legends under the global topic representation are clickable. Clicking the legend turns the line on the chart on and off. If the time series comparison of two or more topics, we can list the topic number in the topics argument. For example, after passing in topics equals 1 and 2, only topics 1 and topic 2 are plotted. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about natural language processing, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.